Last month, we announced the general availability of new Azure SQL auditing capabilities. In this episode, join me and David Trigano to learn more, this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by David Trigano, a program manager on the Azure team. Thanks for joining us today again, David.
Hi, Anna. Thank you for inviting me. It's always a pleasure.
Always a pleasure to have you on the show. And today we're going to be talking about some of the latest announcements in auditing and then diving into some of those capabilities. And I'd love to just kick it off by asking you, you know, what are some of these latest announcements related to auditing for Azure SQL?
Sure. So we have three main announcements. The first one is the new destination that we are now supporting that is now generally available, which is auditing to log analytics workspace. And the second one is auditing to Event Hub, two destinations that allow customers to manage their auditing at scale in a single go-to location. The second feature, or should I say the third capability, is the auditing of Microsoft support operation, allowing customers to track operations that are done by Microsoft support engineers.
Awesome. Thanks, David. Now, you know, we've kind of talked a little bit about, you know, or we've heard about some of these auditing capabilities before. So for it to go generally available, can you tell us a little bit more about what that means, if there were any changes, or how people should think about auditing to Event Hubs and Log Analytics before the GA versus after the GA?
Sure. So before the GA, Microsoft's recommendations are for customers to try this feature, but not to deploy this feature on production environments. Now that those destinations are generally available, we encourage our customers and we support customers that deploy this destination on production environments.
Okay, gotcha. That's helpful. So it's just a fully supported way forward, and we're definitely recommending this for production workloads now. So that's really cool. Now, this third or second option, whichever you might want to call it, of supporting logging of Microsoft support operations. Can you tell us a little bit more about what that is?
Sure, absolutely. So when a customer today opens a ticket because there are some issues on his SQL database, we usually have a Microsoft support engineers that connects to this databases or to the underlying backend, so to the SQL server that runs this Azure SQL database. So when this Microsoft support engineers has to do some operation against the database, against the server, we are basically offering to our customers full transparency on those operations, offering our customers a way to track and to store those operations on their destinations.
Got it. Okay. That's really helpful to know. Now, David, it would be great if you could show us, you know, maybe how easy or how complicated it might be to set this up.
This is super easy, and let me show you how it works.
Awesome.
So I'm here on my Azure portal. I'm on one of my SQL server. You can see that now I have two sections. The first one is Azure SQL auditing, and the second one is auditing of Microsoft support operations. As I told you, Anna, this is super easy. I just have to enable Azure SQL auditing. I'm selecting the destination that I want to send my audit logs. Here, for example, I can select a storage and a log analytics, and then I will have everything written into this destination. I can also select to also fire audit logs, or should I say, operations done by Microsoft support engineers into the same destination. Here you can see that I can basically say, okay, I want to use the same destination. So all my own logs, all my own operations that will be done on the SQL server and all the operations that will be done by Microsoft support engineers will basically be stored in this storage and this log analytics. Now I can also decide to send the Microsoft support operation in a different destination. So for example, I can say, I want to use this storage and I want to use this log analytics. So I don't want to use storage, but I do want to use an event hub. And then very, very easily, I can decide where I want to send my audit of Microsoft support operation and also my audit logs, my regular audit logs in my SQL Server.
Cool. So like you said, this isn't just kind of easy. This is super easy. So that's really great to see. Great that it's so easy to set up. Now, this is just for one Azure SQL instance. Now, what if I wanted to do it kind of at scale? Is there a way that I can do that?
Yes, absolutely. That's a good question. So we recently released a connector using the power of Azure Sentinel, allowing our customers to deploy Azure SQL auditing at scale. So I'm here on Azure Sentinel, the Azure SIEM of Microsoft recently released. So I can go into one of my workspace, select data connectors. Here I will search for Azure SQL database. I will select Azure SQL database, click on open connector page. And here you can see that I have two configurations. So the first one is to enable diagnostic logs on all your Azure SQL database, where I can basically run an Azure policy that will deploy automatically and at scale. And I can decide the scope of this deployment automatically for me. Microsoft will, or should I say Azure, behind the scene will deploy and will configure all my SQL Server with the same destination. So for example, here it's one of my, it's my log analytic workspace that is connected to my Azure Sentinel. So this is for the diagnostic logs. And I also have the same capabilities offered to me to connect my Azure SQL database, or at least all my Azure SQL databases and servers, into a single log analytics workspace using the power of Azure policy.
Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. I hadn't actually seen that before. So you showed us how easily we can do it for one Azure SQL database or even one Azure SQL database server. And then you showed us how using Azure policy and Azure Sentinel, we can actually do it to all of our Azure SQL databases or set a specific policy. So that's really cool. Now, David, I have one last question for you. Once we've collected these logs, like especially if we're using maybe log analytics, how easy is it to look at them and start analyzing them?
Sure. So inside this connector, part of Azure Sentinel, we also added two query samples that you can use to start querying those logs. So here you have a first one. So let me copy paste this one and paste it in my log analytics workspace. So here I will basically run this query, and you will see in live how much time it takes to run this query. And as you can see, within less than 3 seconds, I got almost 3,000 records using the power of Azure Data Explorer. Of course, you can also build your own workbooks using Azure Data Explorer, providing you advanced capabilities to monitor and to investigate your Azure SQL audit logs at scale, and as I said, into a single go-to location.
Wow, thanks, David. This is really cool stuff, you know, and it's almost like this is just the beginning, because now that you have these log analytics capabilities, Event Hub capabilities, Microsoft support operations capabilities, all in general availability, now it seems like the options are kind of endless. You can start querying using Azure Data Explorer and Kusto, or you could even start creating some runbooks to run your own custom kind of logs or checks as these things go forward. Now, to our viewers, do you have any like words of advice when they start to use these services?
Sure. So my first advice will be to start slowly with some pre-production environment. And then when you feel comfortable, go and start to deploy Azure SQL auditing to your production. And then when you feel really comfortable, use the power of Azure Sentinel to deploy at scale within the entire SQL estate of your organization.
Awesome. Thanks so much, David. This has been a really interesting episode. I've learned a lot about Azure SQL auditing, some of the new stuff, and especially how you can kind of expand this to your entire suite of Azure SQL databases. That's really cool. So thanks again for being on the show, David. For our viewers, thanks for joining us. If you like this episode, please give us a like, comment on what you're doing with Azure SQL auditing, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.